Hello peeps, welcome back to the Old Yorkshire Git Tries. My name's Russ and we're playing Final Fantasy 16, part 17. Right, it's been a few days. What we got to do? We got that one up there. Speak with Otto. Keeper of the stores.
Clive. Is everything all right?
Clive. Yeah. Okay. Up the stairs. Otto.
All operations are suspended until further notice.
Yes, Captain.
I'll let the others know.
Doris.
Ah, there you are, Clive. Word of your adventures arrived this morning. Victor sends his thanks.
Good.
I doubt Kupka will miss the fools he sent to catch me. Not a single one of the bearers we saved showed any interest in coming with us. No one seems keen to join hands with an outlaw. Any news while we were away?
None worth mentioning. Gav's still off keeping an eye on the Republican army. Should be back any day now.
Understood. If anyone needs me, I'll be in the map room.
I guess we're going to the map room. How are we all doing today anyway? I hope you're well.
Can't work that one out. There must be better places than the hull of a gutted airship to bury your nose in a book.
Yet this is where she's chosen to be. And I'm sure she has her reasons.
We got a Moogle. Okay. Obviously. Little missions, I guess. Bounties.
Trust I'm not intruding.
Back from your mission? I'm beginning to think your habit of surviving cannot be attributed to luck alone.
One might say the same of you, Vivian Ninetales.
I'll have you know that only 4 attempts have been made on my life, and none was especially memorable. So, to what do I owe the honor? Could it be that you've come for one of my lessons?
Is that so hard to believe?
Lessons? What lessons?
Very well, then. Shall we start with the state of the realm? To absolutely no one's surprise, she finds herself at the mercy of armies and outlaws. Well, mostly armies. Though that's not for want of trying, is it, Clive? But the real question is, how did we get here?
Okay, history lesson.
Long though Samwrek's dominion over northeastern storm has endured, recent days have seen the Blight wrest ever more land from her grasp. For which reason, she has continued to wage war on her rival across the strait, hoping to claim less blackened pastures. But Odin would sooner pawn his sword than Walud relinquish ash. And the Empire pays dearly for every blade of grass bent beneath Sambrequois' boots. Little wonder, then, that Sylvester set his sights on the crystalline dominion, an altogether easier target, possessed of no less ether. It was 5 years ago, while you were busying yourself with the destruction of Drake's Head, that the Empire made its move, subjugating its theretofore neutral neighbor, a nation which could legitimately claim to be the center of the world. Certainly, there is no better place to stage an army. From there, the Holy Empire's reach spans the Twins. The non-aggression treaty was the only thing keeping them in check. But if they truly broke the pact without provocation, it is only a matter of time before others reply in kind. The Holy Empire, the Dalmechian Republic, the Kingdom of Walud, and of course, our friends in Yaran. Who will be left standing, I wonder, when the last drop of blood is spilled?
Are we going to pick a side? That's what normally happens, isn't it? Who do you side
you were
with?
Born in Twinside. Do you not fear for your home?
Oh, dark clouds are wont to gather over the Dominion. Yet, in spite of it all, she has ever endured. And when the storm has passed, I am confident she will remain. Now, as to the matter of payment for today's lesson, complete a simple errand for me and we shall consider ourselves even.
Even? Right.
Return this volume to old Tomes in the shelves. Tell him it was adequate.
I suppose it wouldn't hurt to visit our resident historian.
I guess we're doing a little bit of walking around, acclimatizing ourselves, I guess. Oops. Try in here. Do 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 do.
Norseman Harpocrates.
Now that is a name I have not heard for a long time. So long, in fact, I had half forgotten it was mine. Welcome home, Clive. You were missed, as always.
I believe this belongs to you. Vivian asked me to return it.
Hand over. You go. One book.
Ready? Our resident scholar devours books faster than young Tet does lemon tarts. Would that I could do the same. But alas, I no longer possess the necessary constitution for such indulgence, either in words or tarts. That said, I have continued my search for mention.
I like a nice tart.
Drake's Head, but without access to the great libraries of Oriflam or the Dominion, I regret that I have been able to find little and less. I am sorry.
Please, don't apologize. I'll send word to our associates. See if they can't furnish you with more books.
I fear it is not more books that I require, but the right ones. Mayhap we look in the wrong places. There are still libraries to the north.
I'll see what I can do.
You are too kind. There are not many in this world who would indulge the whims of a tired old historian.
Not too tired to go filching coupon nuts, though. Always got a pocket for him. Nicks him off the Moogle.
Hush now. We all know there's no such thing as Moogles.
What? There's one downstairs.
The twins seem well.
Aye. Yet they laugh far too little for one so young. The loss of their parents weighs heavy on them, however well they hide it. Titan took much from us that night, from some more than others, and the wounds that remain, they are not quick to heal.
Which is why we must give them all the time they need.
That we must. Just as I must give you the time you need to recuperate. Good day, Clive.
Good day.
Clive.
Gav will be back soon. I should get some rest while I can.
Right, return to me quarters.
Not back a blink and you're already off solving everyone's problems. It looks good, Clive. Goes well with the scowl.
I'd had that brand for so long. I'd forgotten what life was like without it. What it was like to be myself. And it's all thanks to you, Talia.
The scalpel did most of the work. Ah, before I forget, a rider was here with a letter from Gav. Otto left it on your desk.
Otto stole it? All right. I'll have a look.
And then you get some rest.
Ah, so now we know where his tattoo's gone.
What could brand for worthy of a letter? I don't know. Perhaps I should just have Blackthorn make me a new one.
Sharon!
Well, don't just stand there gawping.
Ask about the past 5 years. Has it really been 5 years since we left the old place?
I remember it like it was yesterday. You're our leader now, Clark.
Promise me you won't let anything like that happen again. Come what may, Sid will save us. So it weren't much of a conversation then. Nope. I think I've got the best gear on. Sell that Invictus, can't I?
I'll be thankful you got that much.
Flames of Rebirth. See why that costs so much. Using crafting.
You got out else?
Yeah, let's get rid of those.
I'll be thankful you got that much.
Get rid of these.
You got out else?
Used in crafting. Everything else is used in crafting. Okay, we'll leave it at that then.
Finished, are you?
Yeah. But the only crafting we can do is...
What do you need?
The forge.
So, will it be?
Nope, no point in making that. What about reinforcing? Do nothing.
Once the hall's swept, it's over to the Tavern Crown for me.
Still smitten with the serving girl, I think. He's a fair one, all right.
I guess we've got to fill that up. How long is this game going to take? Right, let's check this out. Reading table. Reports, letters, missives addressed to Clive, delivered to the reading table. New message is always arriving, so make it a point to check. Okay. The Republican Army marches on the Empire at Twinside, and the men of the Rock have been summoned to the front. Something big is brewing. I reckon I'll see you're done to wear. upon my return.
What does Gav have to say?
The Republican army is on the march, leaving Randalar in Hugo Kupka's charge. With him and his men occupied with the defense of the capital, they're less likely to trouble us.
Good news, then.
It's more than that. This is our chance, the one we've been waiting for.
What chance?
But look how far we've come. All that we have here, our friends, the hideaway, are they not cause for joy?
5 years. 5 long years. If I could only command this power I've been granted, we might have achieved so much more. But each time I reach for it, it's like something is holding me back.
Summoning an icon exacts a price not easily paid. Your body knows this only too well. It's merely trying to save you from yourself.
And every burden I cannot bear falls to you.
This mission of ours has made me question everything I thought I knew. But one thing has become abundantly clear. The crystals take more than they give. In exchange for momentary comfort, we must endure a lifetime of pain, war after war, loss upon loss. And now? Now they rob us of our very homes, leaving naught but dust and ash.
Yeah, no such thing as a free lunch.
We are trying to change that. And to me, that's no burden.
I know, but...
Try not to forget. We're only here because Joshua gave us a second chance. It would be a pity to waste such a precious gift.
He did. He was there. It wasn't an illusion. I heard him call out. To Ultima. If Joshua is still alive, he'll be looking for that thing.
Do you think he will ever come back?
I know he will. And we must be ready when he does.
Yeah, have a drink. Get that down your neck.
To a world without mother crystals. To Sid.
Right, so what's our next mission?
And so the North is lost.
I knew that the blight spread ever more swiftly, Your Grace. But this is far, far worse.
Excuse me.
It is only a matter of time before the twins are no more. The world marches ever closer to its end, and here we chase shadows. Tell me, brother. Efforts in vain.
Master Clive, a moment if you...
My apologies. I didn't mean to intrude.
Not at all. We were just discussing strategy.
Speak freely, Otto.
It's Martha, from the inn. She's gone missing. Anyway, I'll be in the mess when you've finished.
Very well.
Right, the gathering storm.
What would make Martha leave the rest?
Well, go and speak with Otto. What's this? What we got here? Ah. Okay. It's worth coming out anyway. Don't sleep to get a rest, okay. Can't open that. I was going to put stuff away. You come in. Oh, that's that stone thing. Now, what do I want to replay them for? That's the shop, so. Oh, a jukebox.
Have we any more knuckle pies?
Got any more? Oh, you have to purchase them. Where the heart is. Sorrow's faded form. I like that you can set it as your background music. That's handy. Right, Otto.
What do we know, Otto?
Some lads from the Imperial Garrison in Rosaria started a fight over at Martha's Rest. Blood was spilled, bones were broken. The usual. But somewhere in the middle of it all, Martha vanished without a word to anyone. And that ain't like her, Clive. Something's not right.
Alright, go and find Martha. Of
course it bloody was. Ever since Eastpool, the Empire's been tightening its grip around the Duchy's balls. They've strung up everyone who's ever set eyes on a runaway, claiming they're traitors to the Holy Throne, conspiring to restore the House of Rosfield to power. And now it sounds like the bastards have turned their attentions to the poor bearers, meek enough to stay put. Naturally, old Martha could see the way the wind was blowing, complained that it was getting harder and harder to take bearers in.
And now she's missing. She's fallen into the hands of the Empire. We could be next.
Couple of curse breakers are already on their way to the inn. They should help speed up the search. But if this is as bad as I think it is, you might end up having to save their asses and all.
Don't worry, Otto. I'll make sure everyone gets home safe.
Right, a new quest nearby. Where? Map. Cork and ball. Cock and ball. Boarding deck and then right onto the pier. Okay. Let's go. All aboard the Skylark.
Aside from the holes in my hull,
everything's roses.
The lake water doesn't agree with it, then.
That's one way of putting it. And unless you got some grand scheme to suck the black from the lake like we do in the atrium, that slurry will keep eating away at the timber like young Tech does our lemon tarts. Suppose a coat of pitch might stave off the rot for a moon or so. Assuming we had any pitch. Which we don't. Not any bloody more.
A cheerful soul, innit? A
dozen runs left in him.
Of course, Obelus. Your skiff is our only means of reaching the mainland. Without it, we'd be lost.
Well, I'm glad someone round here sees it that way. To make pitch, you need pitch trees. In case you haven't noticed, live trees are one of the thousand things sorely lacking in the Deadlands. Now, I'm not so unkind as to ask you to fell a faraway forest and lug the logs back here to the mere, which is why we'll be needing a suitable alternative. And it just so happens I once heard the thorny pitchers of Curltail Falls cover themselves in a sticky wax to trap birds and beetles and whatnot. Might be enough to tide me over.
Sounds easier than felling a faraway forest. That's for certain.
Prioritize quest. Slay thorny thistle that a curtail falls. World map. Guess that's where we're going then. Three reeds. Right, let's have a look. I don't think we're going that way. Come on, dog meat. There's the main quest up that way. I've got this one to do first. Just the one spark. Oh, and there's another sparkly over there. You get the sparklies.
Easier than felling a forest, I said. The trees don't have teeth.
Whoa, get them with lightning. Go on, son. Go on. Get that gouges going. Yep. We've got the goodies.
Can't imagine needing any more than this. Time to head home.
Grab this thing. 6 briar clamshells. Nice. Now there's another one along here, if I remember right. Yeah, there it is. Got to kill the claws. More over here. What was that? Discharge 50 blind justice lightning. Okay. 3 clamshells. Don't see any more. Can't go in there. Right, might as well return home then. World map. No, I don't want that. Exit photo mode. Yes. Back. Map. Travel. How are we doing on time? Halfway through. Hopefully there'll be another little quest we can go and do. Oh, yeah, we've got to go down. Down. Ding, ding. All aboard the Skylark. Right. Where's this grumpy old sod?
Finish with that long back, Sid.
Did you find me some wax?
Yeah, yeah, you miserable old bastard.
Ugh, reeks like a chocobo's arse. Oh, I don't suppose the Argo will mind as long as he stays above the waves.
Argo? So your boat has a name? I didn't know.
Yeah. Same as me old man. He was a ferryman himself back before the blight came. The boat's all I have left of him. And thanks to you, he'll sail another day.
Badge of Might. Increases attack by 12. Okay. How do we put them on? Do we work automatically wear them? I should have bought some stone skin tonic. That's not easy to say, stone skin. Bone necklace. Oh, getting lots of stuff. Right, attributes. Gear. You must automatically get to wear that thing then, because it weren't an icon, was it? hang on. Defense by 10. And the rings. Badge of Might by 12. Increase ignition damage by 12%. That could be a lot of damage. Ooh. Bloody hell, I got loads. Excuse me. Let's agree to the higher ones then. Maybe not. That'll do. That'll do. Okay. We got nothing else to do here. Don't know what the dots mean. I ain't got a clue. Doesn't have a, what they call it, a legend. Doesn't have a legend. To say what that means. And I don't know. Open world map. Martha's Rest. Let's go and find Martha. I think we've got enough time. Right.
Fucking Imperials. If they hurt Martha, they'll have the old rest to answer to.
Best off staying where we are for now, I reckon. The boys from the garrison might still be
Let's
nearby.
Get you to a physical, shall we?
I'm sorry.
Sid? What said you'd be coming?
I trust you don't mind. Also thought you might need some help. And it appears he was right.
You, could say that, yes. They're saying the Imperials ascended like a storm. No one was spared their fury. Martha tried to step in and calm things down, but all our efforts got her were a pair of iron shackles and a hard march.
Any idea where?
Judging by their tracks, they headed towards Sorrowwise Bay.
To the Abbey, sheltering Martha's bearers.
The bastards. Jill and I will go after them. You take care of the people here.
We will. But, before you go, one of the locals heard something. He said the soldiers were talking about a culling. I don't know how big this is, but it doesn't sound good. Be careful out there, Sid.
You do the same.
Cole is right. That was no tavern brawl. It was a message.
But a culling. Bearers are the property of the Empire. The garrison wouldn't have the authority to act alone. The orders would have had to have come from higher up.
Right. Let's go and kill some Imperials, shall we? On the road.
Look. Up ahead. Martha, are you hurt?
Don't worry about me. It's them at the Abbey who need you. You have to do something. Tell us what happened. What happened? The damn Black Shields, that's what happened. The Black Shields? The bastards caught wind. The Abbot and I were helping bearers. They were gonna hang us both when the sick rose from their beds. Poor souls turned on the Imperials, distracted them long enough for me to get away.
Then they may still be alive. Martha, do you think you can make it back to the inn? Cole is there with the other curse breakers.
I think so. Thank you, Clive.
Come on, then.
Black Shields. Is this some sort of twisted joke? There has only ever been one Order of Shields in Rosaria, and they fought to defend all her citizens.
It seems a step too far, even for the Empire.
Right. Oh, got another shiny. Go on, let them have it. That it? 5 gil for all of them. Not left nothing behind, did we? Nope. Oh, another shiny. Can't beat a clamshell. Let them have it. Good, Clive. Oh, you bastards.
Are we too late?
There might still be someone inside.
Buggers.
No.
Damn it. I thought you lot were all spent.
Murderers. They drove the bearers to this.
Wait. These two aren't turned. That bitch.
wretch of an innkeeper must have sent them. Colluding with the enemies of the Empire is a serious offence.
And for their crimes shall they be punished. Such is the law. To dwell in darkness that we may purge the night and welcome lasting dawn. On these our swords we swear.
Okay.
How dare you speak those words? Have you no honor?
Clive.
This won't take long.
Go for it, Clive. Woohoo. Bet they wish they hadn't have done that now.
I think so.
Breath of wind. Reduces Geralt's cooldown time by 2 seconds. Ooh. Yeah, but I can only wear three.
I didn't see the abbot. He may still be alive.
The bearers died protecting him, calling upon what little magic they had left in their bodies.
Clive, he's breathing.
Friends of Martha, we're here to help.
Are the Imperials dead?
They are. Every last one.
If only that were true. The Black Shields will return. Rosario will never be saved unless we save her. Tell Martha to beg Sin's aid and tell her this wasn't her fault.
I shall.
Sin, where are you?
In here. We found a survivor.
Clive.
You haven't. Too soon.
He's gone.
Belay that order.
The abbot to rest, but the bearers, they didn't need to die like this.
No, they didn't, but it was their choice. They knew the fate that awaited them and chose to meet it on their terms, fighting for those who fought for them.
Arthur said they rose from their beds, threw themselves at the Imperials so she and the abbot could escape.
I've gathered the bearers' remains. We should consign them to the tide.
There's a drawbridge not far from here. Radix jump. The current's there is swift.
If the abbot was still with us, he'd have taken the duster himself and performed the casting. I'll get someone to...
I'll do it.
Of course. Cole and I will remain here and see to the Imperials.
Right, let's go and do this one. Right, so we're that way. Where is it? Let's have a look at the map, shall we? Got to go the long way round. Oh, hello. Okay. Every now and then you may encounter creatures larger and faster and more ferocious. Okay.
Do you think it's spotted us, Torgal? What am I saying? Of course it has. It's a floating eyeball.
Go on, you can do it. Let's bring on the old limit burst. Right, come on. Get him in. Come on. Finish him off. He's nearly gone. Get. Oh, that's it, is it?
You didn't see that coming.
Come on, give him a fuss. Good boy. Good, he's a good doggy. I've got something special. Here we go, something over here.
That must be the bridge.
So shall the waters cleanse thee of thy burden and bear it out to sea.
And now they are truly free.
I hope so. What of the Imperials?
A pyre was made. It's more than they deserve. We should go back. Cole is worried about Martha.
All right.
Right, you got a better spurt on. Timer's going. The old time is going pretty quick.
Thank you, Founder.
And they called themselves our country. One survived then.
I'm sorry. Before he passed, one of them bade me tell you not to blame yourself.
Doesn't mean I won't. Doesn't mean their blood's not on my hands. Cole said you cast their remains. That was good of you. But it should have been me. This was all my fault.
How? You couldn't have known.
I did. And I turned a deaf ear to the warnings like the fool I am. The rumors started moons ago of black-clad devils descending on villages in the dead of night to slit the throats of sleeping bearers. I assumed it was all just nonsense concocted by the Empire. Nothing but a ghost story meant to make folk think twice about lending a hand to a fugitive bearer.
And in ordinary times you would have been right. What these black shields are doing is unthinkable. Which begs the question, why do it at all? My mother obviously has a hand in this. I cannot make sense of her actions.
And picking what goes on in that woman's head is a job for someone with more time on their hands. Right now, I need swords and men to wield them, preferably big ones. Those Imperials think they can come in here again and threaten my people, they're in for a rude awakening. Oh, before I forget, a Stolas from Otto landed just before you arrived. He asked me to tell you that Gav has returned.
Then we must as well. Will you be all right here, Martha?
We can stay longer if you wish. No need. I'll be ready should the Imperials come calling. Though I wouldn't turn my nose up if you were to lend me a pair of them strapping young curse breakers.
Okay. A new quest is available nearby. See what the quest is. If it's a quick one, we'll get it done. If it's not,
try not to move. You'll only make it worse.
Oi! You there! You handy with that sword of yours? Of course you are. Bet you're a bloody marvel with the thing. Now, question is, are you willing to use it or not? Because a flock of noble chocobos are in need of help.
Chocobos.
You heard me right. Wild birds? Hmm? The big ones? And not just any chocobos at that. Whiteheart and her flock are the bravest birds you ever did see. They protect travelers round these parts from bandits and the like.
Chocobos. Fighting bandits.
It's true. Why, they saved me from a gang of footpads only yesterday. Nasty lot they were, too. And now, they're back, looking to settle the score. Well, go on, then. Don't just stand there. Go and help them.
All right. We'll accept it, but we won't do it today.
All right.
There's a good lad.
Where can I find these chocobos?
I saw him cut across the way over yonder. Rotten scoundrels were driving the poor things towards the old dock. It's a dead end, that is. You save Whiteheart and her flock, you hear me? There ain't a pluckier bird in all the world. She's a hero to us locals. And don't worry.
I think he likes them a bit too much, you know what I mean?
I'm sure I will.
And good luck to you. I give those no good bastards a hiding from me.
Right, prioritise. We'll save it there. Oh, no. There we go. System, save. There we go. Right, folks. Whatever you're up to today, have a cracking day. Next time, we'll go and save some chocobos and crack on with the main quest. But anyway, stay safe, everybody. Until next time, I'll see you.